I am so sick of everybody being sick. I'm sick of being sick, and I'm sick of everybody else being sick. Like, I'm just done. I'm over it. Okay, so first of all, today is Tuesday, because I just saw it on my phone. And Ruben just took Sophia to the doctor. First of all, I know everybody has their own way of doing things, and every family unit is different, and they've been doing certain things, you've been doing certain things for years a certain way. I have been always the mom, the parent, to take the kids, all kids, all the time, every single time, to the doctor's office. And Ruben took Sophia. And I'm kind of feeling a little like somber about it. Anyways, you guys, Sophie has had a fever since, I'm gonna say, Saturday. And Sunday was her big like fever day. That's the day she just did not look good. You could clearly see she didn't feel very good. I am so terrified of my kids getting the flu. Like, I am so scared. None of my kids have ever been diagnosed with the flu except for Sophia and Evan about a year and a half ago when I first started my channel. In fact, I wanna say my very, very first video, if not my very second one, the kids had the flu. Sophia and Evan had the flu. And oh my goodness gracious. I mean, they were like lethargic. They didn't talk. Sophie lost like, I don't know, 6 pounds or something. I mean, it was just horrible. I mean, just heartbreaking to see them both. So I'm gonna insert a picture here because we took a picture. Ruben and I ended up taking them to the ER one evening because we were like, what is this? So on top of not wanting to see them like that, like, you guys, it's very, very scary. Well, Sophie has had the fever, and then today, like I said, I started to say, we went to the grocery store, and when I put her in the car seat when we were leaving, and mind you guys, I must have used like 20 sanitizing cloths that the grocery store provided for all of the baskets. I wiped it before I put the kids in. I wiped it down thoroughly. Once I took the kids out, I wiped their hands with hand sanitizer. Like, I am not irresponsible and stuck my sick kid in a basket and then just pushed the basket back into the carousel thing. I tried to take every single precaution that I could. We went in for diapers and out, and that was it. I also needed coffee, so I got some coffee, and that was it. When I put Sophie in the car seat, I noticed that her little right eye had like mucus in the tear duct, and I was like, oh no, like, that's no, baby girl, you can't have that. And and we came home, and I just noticed that she just accumulated more like white gunky stuff. And so I gave her Motrin. I called the pediatrician's office. I called her doctor's office, and I told them she's had fever for X amount of days. This is what her temperature has been. I really do not want to put her in a cesspool of flu infested little babies and children, because I don't think she has the flu. So if I can avoid taking her in, I want to. So let me tell you guys, that doctor's office was so nice to me, because I was like, I don't want to be judged by, well, gosh darn it, lady, just take your kid in. I know that. Like, I know that I probably should have, but whatever. We always try to make the best decisions, right? As a mom, as a parent, as a caregiver for our children. And so, so they were so accommodating. I mean, they had two nurses call me back. One of them was like, I'm going to hand deliver this, they call it a love note, to doctor whatever, and she will call you back, or I will call you back. And she said, because we appreciate parents who don't, like, oh, they have a little scratch, oh, we're gonna bring them in. Well, don't bring them in, because then that child is now gonna have the flu, because they've been sitting next to 5 kids who have the flu. So we appreciate your efforts to make sure that she does in fact need to be seen by a doctor. And so I called again, and I said, look, you guys, she coughed while she was taking a nap. She was just taking a nap right now, and it kind of woke her up, and her sweet little right eye would not even open. It was shut closed. So I didn't even have to call them back. They called and said, can you come in at 3? It was 2:40. And they said, can you come in at 3? So I called Ruben and I'm like, I do not, please, 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 I do not want to take Evan if I don't have to. Evan is asleep, by the way. And so luckily Ruben was able to leave work and dash over here. And so he was like, babe, do you want me to take Sophia? I'm already in the car. We're already really pressed for time. Let me take her. I've never taken her before. I want to take her. She did not want to go. And I was like, yes. I said, sure. Yes, definitely. You want to take her? Take her. And they drove off. And I'm like, I don't know. I like to control situations. And I'm not in control of the situation. So anyways, you guys, please, please say a little prayer for my Sophie. I don't want her to get the flu. However, on a fantastic note, I got my rear end on the scale today, you guys, and I have lost 5 pounds, and I didn't get on early in the morning. So I'm not gonna become obsessed with the scale, but I did get on about, I don't know, 2 o'clock, and I have lost 5 pounds. So I'm going to keep you guys updated on my keto diet. I really want to, we have not had time to go grocery shopping. Every evening the kids have something going on. This week is a huge week. It is birthday week here in our house. Tomorrow is Ruben's birthday, and then the day after is Evan's birthday. And so, and then this weekend is Evan's party. Sunday is my dad's birthday. So it's just, we don't have time to go like big bulk keto diet grocery shopping. So, but once we do, and we do find the time, I will do a haul, and then I'm going to try my best to show you guys kind of the meals that are my go-to meals and stuff like that. And I've read some really great recipes and stuff. So I will certainly share that with y'all. But if you could, in the meantime, I know you're gonna see this tomorrow, and this was yesterday, but she could still use your prayers. So please, please keep my baby girl in your prayers, that she does not get the flu, that nobody else gets sick. Like, I'm done with everybody getting sick. So anyways, I wanted to update you guys, but I'll let you know what the doctors tell her when she comes back with her daddy.
Hi. Hi, little pumpkin. Come here, little muffin. How are you feeling, my baby?
A little better.
A little better?
Yeah.
Hi, princess.
I got a sticker.
You got a sticker?
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Really awesome.
You feel really awesome?
Sit down, Papa.
All right, you guys, so Ruben and Sophia obviously just got back.
Amanda initially just floated the idea of me just staying with Evan, but I kind of wanted to
take Sophie.
He did, he wanted to take Sophia.
Because she was very nervous and scared about an S-H-O-T.
But did you get any, Sophie? Did you get any shots?
No, she did not.
And I think somewhere in her mind, she had this preconceived notion that because daddy goes, she won't get one.
She's not gonna get hurt.
Yeah.
That's cute. That's really cute. So anyways, Ruben said that they tested her for the flu, and oh, thank you, Jesus, she does not have the flu. She just has accumulated mucus, which...
Yeah, and this weird gunky stuff in her
eye. That makes no sense to me, but whatever. She got eye drops for it, and then she got a prescription for a cough. I'm not sure if we're gonna fill it or not because she doesn't really have a cough. Like, that's not why I took her in. So my whole fear was like taking any kids into the emergency, or not the emergency, but the doctor's office, because there's just so much flu.
There were some sick kids in there.
And thankfully she doesn't have it, but now I'm like, well, now, you know, make sure she's got their antibacterial. And Ruben put her, what is it called?
Hand sanitizer.
Anyways, you guys, so my little baby girl told Ruben, Ruben was texting me the whole time he was there, that she wanted some nieve.
Yes.
Ruben now knows what nieve is.
Yes.
It's chocolate ice cream.
Nieve is ice cream. So she wanted ice cream. So I went to the store real quick and I got her some chocolate ice cream. And just by default, Evan will get some because he's a fantastic brother. And
he loves ice cream.
He loves ice cream. And then I got some little cones for the kids. You guys, this is proof that I'm going to kick major booty with the keto diet, because I was like, I'll get y'all some ice cream. So I got some ice cream, and then I found these. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them yet, but they're sugar-free chocolate chips.
Oh, wow.
I know. So I've seen a few keto dessert recipes call for them, but I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm thinking of melting some of this with some peanut butter, right?
Peanut butter?
Just to like...
Chocolate?
Yeah, just to like dip my finger in it. I don't know.
You can't like... the cone, babe, or?
No. So, and then I'm gonna do a little...
Ranch.
I got ranch because we had no ranch. And for me, I can't just eat meat. Like, I need something wet. And then I got heavy whipping cream because we didn't have any of this either. And this is good. I don't know how I'm gonna use it, but I know what you're gonna choke your mouth.
This morning?
I did get my coffee.
What'd you get?
The Houston, my favorite, because it has coconut. So for my coffee this morning, you guys taste it. I got the Houston blend coffee from our local HEB, which is like a coconut flavored coffee, and then I put sugar free vanilla sweetener in it, so it feels delicious. But let's get to Sophie. Hey, my beautiful baby. How are you feeling, love muffin? Look, I want you to show everybody your eye. Okay, so can you guys see my little Sophie's eye and how yucky it looks? Yeah, to your little baby, to my little baby. So we got her some eye drops. And then if you can see, look at mama. Her sweet little skin gets so irritated with mucus. And so we have been treating that. I put Neosporin on it at night, but the doctor suggested just Vaseline. So I'm gonna do that for my baby girl. How do you feel, Sophie?
I feel like a snow cone.
You guys, thank y'all so much. Oh, there went the snow cones. Thank y'all so much for watching today. We are just gonna start dinner and then snuggle with the kids, because that's just what I want to do with them. I want to snuggle. It's an ugly, nasty, cold, rainy, sprinkly day here in San Antonio, and it's good snuggle weather. Reuben was kind enough on Sunday to make me lots of chicken, so I may either have that. We have some chicken. I'm probably going to bake and then throw in some veggies for a side. So anyways, you guys, thank y'all so much for watching, and thank you for prayers from my Sophie. Sophie, can you say thank you for my prayers?
Thank you for my prayers. See you tomorrow. I love you.